This time, let's try to learn how to create a ternary solution database. So this is the ternary phase diagram for the copper, silver, nickel system. Okay. So in each actually binary system, for example, silver and the copper binary system, you have phase diagram like this. You have liquid phase and FCC one, FCC number two phase. So FCC have the miscibility gap, and the liquid have the complete solution. And if you look at the copper and the nickel binary system, at the low temperature, you have the miscibility gap between the two copper side, the copper rich side and nickel rich side. And with the increasing of temperature, it become one FCC solution, and then liquid have almost ideal solution. And if you look at the silver and the nickel binary system, there's the both silver and the nickel is FCC. However, there's the almost no solubility each other, no mutual solubility. So it's a very big miscibility between two. And also even in the liquid phase, you have liquid miscibility. So in this ternary system, silver, copper, nickel ternary system, there's the only FCC solution which containing silver, copper, and the nickel as a species. And this have the miscibility gap, and also this ternary system containing liquid solution. So there's only two solution in this ternary system. So it's rather simple to do the ternary modeling. And one of the things you have to be careful in this FCC solution is the nickel is the magnetic. So nickel have the certain magnetic property. So when you create FCC solution, you have to consider magnetic property as well. Okay. So luckily this ternary system is already assessed by the Liu and the Tal in the 2008. So in this paper, so we're going to look at their paper and try to create this ternary database. So if you look at the Liu and et al.'s paper, they use the both FCC and the BCC. They use the model number one. So one sublattice random mixing model for both FCC and the BCC solution. So this is the general description of their Gibbs energy for the solution phase. So Gibbs energy GM in this case is this is the solution, and phi means a certain solution. So in this case FCC or liquid solution. So Gibbs energy of molar Gibbs energy of solution is sum of the mole fraction times pure Gibbs energy of each species plus RT XA lone XA XI lone XI sum. So this is the ideal entropy term. And then you can start to have the so L AGCU and X AGCU parameter. So this is binary AGCU parameter. And this is AL AG nickel, so binary AG nickel parameter. And this is Cu nickel, so binary Cu nickel parameters here. And then you have the ternary excess parameter. So these three is the binary parameter, and this is ternary parameter for the ternary FCC or BCC solution. And each binary parameter here, Lij is expressed by this term, which is the Rader-Lukister type of the polynomial. So here, Lm is the model parameter, and which is connected to the xi, xj power m. And then you, on top of that, you have the mole fraction xag or xcu, or xa, xi, xj, 1, 1 parameter is connected automatically here. So this is typical Rader-Lukister type of the parameter. And also this ternary excess term is expressed in this way. So ternary excess term is the expressed by the mole fraction of Ag, Cu, and the nickel power 1, 1, 1. And then you have L0 parameter, which is connected additional power 1 of Ag. And then L1 parameter is connected to the additional power of the Cu. And then L2 parameter is additionally depending on the mole fraction of the nickel power 1. Okay, so these three parameter is used to describe the ternary excess parameter. Okay, So let's try to look at what kind of parameter they really have in this what they optimized in this system. Okay, so this is the table for the summary of their model parameter. So this is liquid phase and this is FCC solution phase. So in case of liquid solution, you can see that here AGCU, AGCU. So this is L0, L1 parameter for the AGCU binary system, and Cu nickel binary system, Ag nickel binary system, and then this three parameter is ternary excess parameter. So let's look at how to create this kind of the liquid solution, ternary liquid solution. Okay, so I already actually created this the ternary solution. So in this case, I assigned name of this solution as ACN underscore solution. So you go here and you create a new, and then in this case, I create this solution name. And then because I know I need three species, Ag, Cu, and the nickel, so I take each of these one from the FT-LIGHT compound database, compound from the FT-LIGHT database. So for example, in case of Ag, I took the FCC and the liquid phase. Same thing for the Cu, FCC and the liquid phase, and the nickel, FCC and liquid phase inside of the my functions for the this ACN solution database. Okay, and then now you can add solution phase. So by clicking here, you can add the solution, and I already created FCC and the liquid solution. As I mentioned, FCC is the magnet have the magnetic property, especially the nickel have the magnetic property. So when you create once lattice polynomial model number one, you have to always select magnetic actually in the beginning when you create this FCC solution. And in case of liquid, you don't have the magnetic term, so you don't have to select the magnetic actually option. Okay, so let's look at the liquid. So if you look at liquid, so here you go. So liquid have the three sublattices, Ag, Cu, and the nickel. So when you go to the sublattice, you can add. So for example, when you go to the sublattice, because it's one sublattice, go Ag, and then do add the species, and then I create with the three species, and each of them I say I assign it Ag and Cu, and then nickel. Okay. And then for each Ag, for the Ag, I assigned end member. So end member, and then that Ag end member is Ag, and formula is Ag. Gibbs energy of the solution for this Ag end member is Ag sharp liquid phase, because this is liquid Ag. And the same thing, liquid copper, and then liquid nickel. So all three of them, or all three and the member Gibbs energy is assigned in this way. And then now you can start to add the binary interaction parameters. So for example, if you click this one and then push the control button and then click the Cu, then you do the mouse right click, and then you can add Prager-Williams G excess parameter, and then Rayleigh-Kiss type of the parameter in this case. Then you can say L0 parameter, L0, so L parameter power I, L0 is this parameter. So if you look at the PowerPoint again, so here, so if you compare this one, so where is it? So this one, L0 AGCU is this one, L0. So L0 of the Ag and Cu is this value. And when you look at actually, when you enter this Rayleigh-Kiss type of the parameter, one thing you have to be careful is you have to look at the order of the A and the B here. So AB power I, A minus YA minus YB power I. And then if you look at our previous expression here, so you see here Lij is xi minus xj power m. Yeah. So lm parameter is xi minus xj power m. So I minus j. Okay. So something like A minus B. So it's the same order. So we can take the same same number for the same actually the parameter for each actually power of the each L power of the Redlich's type parameter. Okay. So for example, L1 is this value. Then if you go here. L1 is the 660.74 minus 2.315 times temperature 1 power 1. And then if you look at it, it's exactly the same value. Okay. So in some papers, in the some articles, they define actually this parameter instead of xya minus yb or xa minus xb, you say xb minus xa power I. Then you have to use the opposite sign for this kind of parameter. So when you look at actually the assessment paper, and you see that actually their parameter, you have to always go to, you have to check the, what's the definition of the their formula for the parameter, and then you have to assign the proper number. Okay. So I add one by one all this actually number here. So for example, let's look at all these numbers. So I add kappa, L0, L1, and here, and then silver and the nickel, L0 and L1 parameter. And then now let's go to this AgCu nickel. So power 0 was the AgCu nickel. So Ag, if you look at it here, A is Ag, and the B is Cu, and C equal to nickel. So Ag, Cu, nickel, but A for the power 2. So this was power 111 by default. And then when it was the L0 for the ternary parameter, that have the additional power for the Ag side. So I say Ag power 2, and then nickel and the copper power 1 and 1. Okay. So this is same as the L0 for the ternary L0 parameter, okay? And then ternary L1 parameter, ternary L2 parameter, so power 2 for the nickel side, okay? So in this way, I can add one by one for the all the binary and the ternary parameter. One of the things you have to be also careful in this actually the solution is the ternary interpolation technique. So whenever you have the ternary system, you have to always assign what's the, actually the interpolation technique to calculate Gibbs energy for the ternary system. So in this actually the paper by Liu and et al, they didn't actually specify what's the ternary interpolation technique, but there's the this kind of the ternary interpolation technique. When you have the ternary system or higher than ternary system, then you can estimate Gibbs energy of the ternary solution from the binary model parameter first, and then you can add additional ternary excess Gibbs energy to calculate the ternary Gibbs energy at the given composition. Okay, so when you have A, B, C system like this, there's the many different kinds of the estimation technique for the Gibbs energy in the ternary system from the binary model parameter or binary Gibbs energy. Okay. So for example, this kind of the ternary interpolation technique, we call it as a Kohler type. So for example, when you have the Gibbs energy, if you want to calculate the Gibbs energy at the P point here in the ternary system, and under this kind of Kohler type of interpolation technique, we estimate the Gibbs energy of this ternary point from the this binary actually Gibbs energy. Okay, so this is kind of symmetric. So along the actually P, so from the corner to the P, you can draw the straight line. Then we take this one A point to estimate Gibbs energy of the P. And then same way, P point and C point to estimate Gibbs energy of the P. Okay. And then there's another type, so-called the tube type of the interpolation technique. So So two type of interpolation technique. We assume that one of the species, in this case is one, number one component is asymmetric from the two and three. Okay, two and three have the similar behavior, but component one have the different behavior. So A is different from the B and C. Then we can use this kind of tube interpolation technique. Under the tube interpolation technique, the Gibbs energy of the P is estimated from the ISO amount point of the component A. So this one in the binary A point and the C point, which have the ISO composition range of the A component. Okay. And then also taking this point, which is similar to the color type actually interpolation. So these two and this point. So this is asymmetric type of the interpolation technique, and we call this kind of technique in general as a tube interpolation technique. Okay. And the color interpolation technique compared to that, color interpolation technique assume that all three have the similar chemical behavior. Okay. So we call color type of interpolation technique as a symmetric type of interpolation technique, and this is tube type of interpolation technique as asymmetric type of interpolation technique. So one of the components is different from the other two. Okay, and then there's also the very famous actually the interpolation technique called the Muggiano interpolation technique. Okay, so in the Muggiano interpolation technique, so the Gibbs energy of the P point here is estimated by the ABC three corner here by directly, by vertically actually the extrapolated out to the binary system. So P from the P point, you draw the straight line, vertical line to the one and two binary system. That's the A point. And similarly, B and C was taken from the, can be taken from the binary Gibbs energy, and then that actually used for estimation of the P in the terminal system. So physically, it is very difficult to say what's the meaning of the Muggiano interpolation technique. But if your binary Gibbs energy expression is done by the Redlich's type of the polynomial. So if your binary excess parameter, the G excess parameter is expressed by the Redlich's type of the polynomial, this kind of the Muggiano interpolation technique is very easy to express the ternary actually the Gibbs energy by using the Redlich's type of the binary polynomial. So that's actually mathematically very convenient. So that's why, that's actually one of the reasons why Muggiano introduced this kind of the interpolation technique. And luckily or unluckily, in the thermocalc software, this Muggiano interpolation technique is used by default. So a lot of people don't mention what's the interpolation technique, especially when they use the thermocalc software. That it means this actually ternary interpolation technique is the Muggiano type of the interpolation technique. So you can just pre-assume that there's no specific actually the method or the interpolation technique for the ternary solution. You can by assume it is the Muggiano type of the interpolation technique. Okay, and then also you can combine the many other kinds of the interpolation technique. In the fact stage, we provide all these kinds of the interpolation technique. But personally, I don't use that much actually Muggiano interpolation technique. I personally use the most of the case color type of interpolation technique or tube type of interpolation technique. And these two actually have the more physical meaning when you introduce this kind of interpolation technique. So if you go back again, so in this case, so whenever you have ternary system, you have to assign what kind of interpolation technique you are using in the fact stage. Okay, so you click all these three actually the species by pushing. So when you click AG, push the control key down, push down the control key, and then you click additional two species. So all three species, and then do the mouse right click, then you can have this add or edit ternary interpolation technique, okay, of this ternary interpolation. And if you do that, you can have this kind of the option. Okay. So AgCu nickel. So in the fact set, you can simply move around and then assign what kind of interpolation technique you want to use. You want to use for each binary system, from the each binary system. So for example, this is tube and this is Mujan. So if you're actually using this one, tube, tube, and then here color. So this is, in general, we call it as a tube interpolation technique. Okay. And or you can use this kind of thing, the color, color, color. So this is the ternary color interpolation technique. Okay. So in this case, as I mentioned, because this paper, when they actually do the assessment for this paper, they use the small calc. So they, by default, they use the Muggiano type of the interpolation technique from each binary system. Okay. So if there's the, so that's why you have to use the, this Muggiano actually interpolation technique, for the liquid solution in this case. Okay. Good. So this is how we create the liquid solution. Okay. Now let's look at the solid solution, solid FCC solution. So the channel actually, the channel actually approach for to create the ternary FCC solution is same, except as I mentioned, FCC is the, have the magnetic property. So when you actually create the solution, you have to, click the, you have to choose the actual option for the magnetic, okay, in the beginning. And then you have the Ag, Cu, nickel as a component. Again, each end member Ag, Cu, nickel is the FCC and FCC and FCC. So Ag and the Cu, there's a no magnetic term, but if you go to the nickel, you have to assign its magnetic actual property. So in this case, the moment, magnetic momentum for the nickel is 0.52, and then it have the Curie transition temperature at 633 Kelvin. So how can I know this one? You have to check in the compound again. So for example, nickel. So if you go to the nickel in the Aptilite database, nickel FCC, you see this moment, magnetic momentum for the nickel FCC phase is 0.52, and then the transition temperature is Curie, magnetic transition temperature is 633 Kelvin, and p-tect is 0.28, because this is FCC solution. Okay, so all of them is actually done. So here, 0.28 for the p-tect. Yeah. So it's all good, and then you can, similarly, also you can actually assign the ternary interpolation technique as a Muggiano interpolation technique in this case. And you can assign each binary L parameter, each access parameter. Okay. And then even you can add each ternary access parameter. So if I go back again here. Sorry, but this one. So if I look at the parameter again, so here you see FCC. L1, L parameter for the each binary system, and then ternary parameter. And then by the way, the 1-0 parameter here was a little bit strange. So minus 85,000, I think this was minus 85. This is simply typo. The comma here is actually in the wrong place. So 85,000. Okay, so 85,000 joule per mole. That's actually added in the my database. So go back again here. So ternary, so 85,000 for the L0 for the ternary parameter. So 0 is the AG in this case. Okay. And then there's the two additional parameter which is the little bit strange here. So as you can see here, there's the TC parameter and then beta parameter. So this was a little bit actually ambiguous, what's actually TC and the beta parameter. So TC is typically the Curie temperature, the transition temperature, magnetic transition actually temperature parameter, L kind of 0 and 1. So it's like L0 and L1 kind of access parameter, but it's for the Curie temperature. So TC and 1, 0, TC 1, okay, in FCC solution. And theoretically, you have to specify what this, which binary actually have this kind of parameter. And it is not very well actually described here, but this is just after the CUNI access parameter. So I assume that this TC parameter and the beta parameter is also for the CU nickel binary system. Okay, so that's what I did. So let's look at how I enter this parameter, because this is a little bit different. So let's look at it carefully. So if you go here, some of the parameter here. So for example, if you CUNI to the mouse right click, and there's the Bragg Williams, but if you look at a little bit more. So if you go here and here, simple ladder register, and then there's TC and the beta. So this is the magnetic temperature actual parameter in the Redlich's type, and the beta parameter. This is momentum, magnetic momentum parameter in the Redlich's type. So you have to click this one, then you are going to have this kind of parameter, TC, access parameter binary, and then this is zero, L0 kind of parameter. So T0 type of the parameter, and then the value is, if you look at it here, so TC0, minus 935.5. So that's the parameter here. So this is excess the Curie temperature or magnetic temperature parameter for the CUNI binary system. Although it is not specified here, I assume this is CUNI binary system. Okay. And then here again, so L1 for the TC, so it's TC1 parameter. So minus 594.9. Okay. And then now you have beta parameter. So here you see this is beta parameter and zero. And this one is minus 0.7316. And then again for this one, beta one minus 0.3174 minus 0.3174 for the beta L1 parameter. Okay. So this is the how we create FCC solution database. This magnetic actually parameter is sometimes very important, especially if you are interested about the changing of the magnetic property in the binary system, you have to add a proper actual parameter for this correction term for the TC and then also beta parameter. Okay, so once you finish it, then you can always and then save it, and then also you can always add this one into your database pool, so you can use this one in the Eclipse program or in the phase island program for the ternary calculation. Okay, so this is the everything I want to actually show you today for the ternary solution database development. So you can, if you have the already some assessment data, then you can simply create ternary solution by using this kind of the by using the solution program like this. Okay. So this is the metallic system, but if you even you have the oxide system or the salt system, you can do step by step like this. Okay, and there's the many other examples also in the fact page in help menu here. If you go help and then example here, then you can find the more example probably. Okay, and if you have the question, you can always continue to. Okay, thank you very much. So if you have any question, you can please send me email or please contact me. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.